question about like other languages I wrote before Go. I wrote, so back in the day when I did like Live Journal and stuff, that was all in Perl. And for the things that were performance critical, that was in C. So sometimes it was C embedded in Perl. Sometimes it was C by itself, Perl by itself. Like Memcached was all written in C. And then, you know, I saw other scripting languages come, like Python came, and it was like okay, better in some ways, but not interesting enough to like replace Perl. Likewise, Ruby came, and it was okay, but it wasn't great. JavaScript came, and I was like, well, whatever. Like, I'll do it in the browsers. But it's like, it wasn't enough to go to Node.js. Like, I had already experienced callback hell writing big servers in Perl. Like, I wrote HTTP load balancer in Perl. I wrote an XMPP server that ran all of LiveJournal's chat traffic in Perl. And so I'd already written crazy event-based callback hell things in Perl. And so I saw Node.js, and I was like, no thanks. And then, let's see, at Google, they write everything in like Java, C++, and Python. So I was like, whatever. I mean, I've written things in Java, and it is what it is. It's painful and boring and verbose, but it gets the job done if you can deal with like slow startup latencies and stuff. And so I was never excited about it. I wrote it. I worked on Android for a while, and I had to write Java. And you know, I didn't enjoy my life as much if I were writing not Java. And then C++ is cool, but it's so gigantic of a language that nobody knows all of C++, and everyone speaks a different dialect of C++. And then you have to agree on conventions for your team about like what subset of C++ you're gonna use. So that was kind of annoying. And Python, you know, I had to write Python at Google, and you know, it's like the same thing. It's slow, it explodes at runtime, and it can only do one thing at a time. And uses a lot of CPU to do one thing at a time. So it also has the whole callback hell thing. And there's things like, I don't know, there's like three different event-based systems on Python that are all fighting to be the one based event-based thing to do like fibers and, you know, green threads or whatever they call them. And of course, if you get a library in Python that uses one of these event-based worlds, it doesn't work with libraries written for the other two event-based worlds. So like nothing composes well. So I wasn't excited about that. And then I had this project that I wanted to write the storage system to index all my stuff. And I had to pick a language for it, so I didn't want to use C++, even though I knew I was going to have to do like low-level memory indexing sort of search stuff. I wanted to use C++ for that, but I didn't want to use C++ because it's not fun. I didn't want to use Python or Perl because they're bad at writing servers. They're bad at dealing with lots of connections and serving lots of things because you need to do event-based thing. I didn't want to use Java because it's not fun. Even though like threading is a little bit easier. So I saw Go, and it's like, Go lets you write low-level code when you want to write low-level code, but most of the time you just write high-level code and it feels like a scripting language. You know, you have closures and you know, built-in maps and all this stuff. So Go is this like weird hybrid between like C and JavaScript or something. You know, like it has high-level features, but even that alone wouldn't be enough for me to switch to Go. The cool thing about Go is the Go routines, that I can write blocking code and I never have to deal with like callbacks, unless I really want to use a callback, but in general, you just block. If you have an API, you just call it and you wait, and it could take hours, and you don't have to worry about it like consuming a thread or wasting memory. And so you could have hundreds of thousands of these Go routines all blocking, doing whatever, and your code, when you read your code, rather than like chasing callbacks and like or indenting, or like futures and promises and all this noise, your code just reads top down the page. And it doesn't matter if it takes hours to execute or you have a long-running connection, like streaming data to someone over WebSockets and they're actually are connected for hours, you can see like here's a for loop in my code, and when something comes in, I send it to them on WebSockets. And you see like three lines of code where it's like for receive this from a channel, send to the person. And it's really liberating to write code that's readable and that you can follow. And so I love Go routines. I don't love everything about Go, but I accept it. It's better than any alternative I found. I mean, I'm excited about Rust in different ways, but it still doesn't feel like as fun and powerful and liberating and like, you know, get shit done as Go. I feel like whenever there's something I want to write in Go, like I can whip it up in no time. And I've never felt that previously except for Perl. But Perl is no longer kind of as powerful as I need it to be.